In this session of the PowerPoint tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to get started with PowerPoint by using a blank presentation. So basically, this is for the absolute beginner that has never used PowerPoint before. So we open PowerPoint, and this is one of the first options that we get presented here to open a blank presentation. So we'll click on blank presentation, and at this point, we can start utilizing this presentation. Now, one of the things that I wanted to mention before we get to actually start designing a presentation, I'm going to explain just a few of the components that you'll see on the general interface for PowerPoint. So on the top here, notice that you have the file option. So basically the menu system here, the home option, then the insert, draw, design, transition, animation, slideshow, and record, and so on. If you're new to PowerPoint, you explore what is under each one of those options. Anytime we click on any of these options here, the menu items here, notice that it presents us with the new set of icons. And this whole thing here in the very top of the application, this is referred to as the office ribbon. So the ribbon is based on the various options from the menu, and it provides us with a set of icons grouped together based on their functionality for the functions that we are performing once we click on that particular option in the menu or that menu item. It's designed so that you use those tabs and these menu items as part of the ribbon progressively. So meaning as you get started with the initial presentation, you are designing the slides, you'd use the home tab. Then as you insert other components in your presentation, then you start using the insert tab where you're inserting images and icons and shapes and all this other stuff. Then you move to the design mode and transitions and animations, and then you present it. Now on the very top, notice that you also have the search. This is where you can do a Microsoft search if you're not sure as to how to change something or how to do, let's say, the animation. You can simply type a particular word and then you click on it and it will take you to that particular section on how to do animations for slides. On the top right, notice that because this is PowerPoint 2021 for Office 365, this has some additional functionalities such as sharing this with others on the web and also recording the slides as well. And we'll get to that. Now on the right-hand side, notice that you'll have this designer tab. The designer tab, this is, depending on what you're doing, it's going to give you ideas on how to design this. Now the designer component is part of Office 365 subscription. So if you do not have it in your computer, most likely you don't have 365. So basically it's giving us some ideas how to start with the design of this presentation. Now, further in the bottom here, you have the how many slides you have in the presentation, some accessibility tools, or some of the tips here, how to use accessibility and titles and so on for various slides. Then on the far right here in the bottom, you have the notes area. If you want to show and hide the notes, and we'll get to the notes. And then you have the normal view. So this is the normal view of what you see currently. You have the option on the left here for the particular preview of the slides, then in the middle area you have the actual content of the slide. Now if we had more than one slide as part of this presentation, you can also see here the slide sorter where you can move slides around and change the order of those particular slides. Now in our case I have only one, so I can't move much with those. Then you also have the reading view, which is not really going to be too helpful in our case here in PowerPoint. And then you also have the option to for the slideshow. So this is where you present this slideshow when you have content as part of your slides. So if I click right now, this there's nothing in it, but that's how I'll present it. And then the plus and minus here, this is where you can zoom into the slides and out as well as part of your slides. So these are the general interface components of PowerPoint. So now let's go ahead and design our first presentation. And we can close these panels on the right-hand side, which basically are tools related to a specific function within the presentation. In PowerPoint, you have different types of slides. Now, this is what it's called a title slide. And you can check those types of slides here. Notice under layout over here, you have title slide, title and content. You have section headers, two contents, or two sets of content, for example, two charts or so on, comparison, and so on. But most of the common content that you'll use for your presentations are going to be the title slide, which typically is the first one, and then title and content. So those are the two primary ones that you'll be using. To enter content in this presentation, we simply start typing. And I'm simply clicking on these boxes at this point. Now to insert a new slide, notice I have this option here on the under the Home tab, and I have New Slide. If I click on the drop-down, I can pick what type of new slide I want to pick, or I can simply click on New Slide on the upper part of it, and notice it says also Control M as a shortcut for you to insert a new slide. So click on it, and now notice by default it's going to give us the title here and content. Now we can simply click to start typing the title and also click here to enter the content, which we can enter the content as bulleted lists, or we could use any of those components as part of the content. And we'll get into the charts and other components later in this tutorial. So for now, I'm going to just start typing the second slide. And these are, by the way, best practices when getting started with PowerPoint. You want to first make sure that you complete the outline. A lot of individuals, they get stuck with just on the first slide and making it look better and so on. So it's best if you're going to present for a conference or for a meeting or in a lecture, then it's best to just continue creating 10 slides or 15 slides and just enter the main components or the main ideas in there as part of your outline. Next, you'd insert the images and multimedia to enhance your presentation. And then finally, you want to review and revise the content of your presentation and enhance the visuals so it looks very professional. And now to insert a new slide, I can simply click on New Slide. We have three slides so far. And at this point, we want to save it. We press Save here on the top, or so if I press save, now notice it's going to try to save it on one drive, but you can choose to save it under other locations or under documents, or you can choose more locations and then come here under browse and pick where you want to save this presentation and then press save. The other option is for you to press file here and choose save as and then pick where you want to save it. Now, let's suppose that we wanted to see how this presentation looks so far. So this technically would have taken us, without my explanations, would take about 15-20 seconds to design. If I wanted to present it, you can either go here under slideshow on the top and press from the beginning to present it, or you can go here in the bottom under slideshow and click on it. If I start from the very beginning here, I can click on from the beginning, or if I press slideshow in the bottom, it will start from wherever you are in your presentation. So start from the beginning, and this is how it looks currently with no enhancements or anything like that. If I wanted to make this look sharper, and provided I have my outline correctly set, you can go here under the Home tab, and notice on the right-hand side, we have this designer option. So if we click on Designer, it will generate a variety of designs automatically using the Microsoft Intelligence Services. Basically, this is connecting to Microsoft and getting ideas on how to design this presentation to make it look more professional. So here we can simply click on any of these designs and it will apply to the slides. And then go to the next one and click on any of those that you'd prefer. Notice that once I come back to each slide here, notice I'm presented now with additional options as part of the design that I could switch to. And now if I wanted to preview this again, if I go here under slideshow and go from the beginning and I click on each slide to advance them, my presentation is pretty much ready. And one quick tip before I move to the next option here is that you can actually start the presentation by also pressing the F5 key on the keyboard.